That was 70 years ago, and today the king will wear the crown. And his mother there, he was 4 years old. Amazing to take that trip down memory lane, that history, and now history created today, and the world will be watching. But of course, there will be significant differences between King Charles III's coronation and that of his late mother's. His ceremony is expected to be slimmed down and modernised, while still holding fast to key traditions and, of course, rituals.
The scaled back coronation service and procession, a reflection of changing public attitude 7 decades on and Britain's current cost of living crisis.
For 900 years, Westminster Abbey has been the setting for a sovereign's coronation. Kings and queens since Edward I sitting in the coronation chair. Like the late Queen Elizabeth, King Charles will also be anointed in St Edward's chair and crowned with the same solid gold and exceptionally heavy St Edward's crown. His ceremony is set to hold fast to core elements of his mother's coronation, which he watched as a four-year-old. But while still being undeniably lavish and regal, there'll be key differences too. Unlike the late Queen's 8,000 guests from 129 nations, King Charles has invited 2,000 guests, including local volunteers and charity workers. And while the young Queen Elizabeth was crowned alone, Prince Philip watching on, King Charles will be crowned alongside Camilla, his queen consort.
She will have a mini version of the ceremony that he has. So he is anointed and crowned first, and then she will follow in a kind of watered-down version appropriate for the queen consort.
Camilla is set to be crowned with Queen Mary's crown, which has been taken out of the Tower of London to be resized ahead of the ceremony. The royal family avoiding the more recent Queen Mother's crown, which bears the controversial Koh-i-Noor stone, one of the largest cut diamonds in the world. In 1953, Queen Elizabeth's coronation was a breakthrough in the history of broadcasting, the first to ever be televised at her request. Australia didn't have television yet, so we listened in over the radio. We'll join viewers worldwide in watching King Charles' coronation and the coronation procession, which will also be paired back. While they'll arrive for the coronation in the palace's newest carriage, the Diamond Jubilee State Coach, they'll depart in the oldest, the iconic Gold State Coach, which has been used in every coronation since 1831.
There are very few monarchies which have retained coaches working of this age, and therefore it's an incredibly special thing to see, really harking back to a couple of centuries earlier, a world we probably can't imagine today.
King Charles may prefer the shorter procession. The late Queen Elizabeth once referred to the coach as a horrible ride, very uncomfortable given its poor suspension. And that iconic moment at Buckingham Palace, where the young Queen, now wearing the Imperial State Crown, waved to the crowds from the balcony, will be repeated 70 years on by her son, King Charles, the oldest new monarch in British history.
Just looking at that vision and Charles there as a little boy on the balcony when his mother was her coronation. Let's go to Dickie Arbiter now, because 70 years on, that little boy, it's now his turn. Just how different will it be though, Dickie?
Well, the service for a start will be different, Ali. The service in 1953 was about 3 hours, 15 minutes. Mm. Today's service will be just over 2 hours, so that is certainly slimmed down. The size of the congregation is different. In 1953, it was 8,000. This year, it'll be 2,200. And the route, the ceremonial route this year, is about 1.4 miles. Now, in 1953, it took in a large chunk of the West End and was about just under 5 miles. 29,000 military marched in that procession, with 15,000 lining the routes, 7,000 police along the route, 1,000 military police augmenting the Metropolitan Police. So it was a very much larger parade, but it's not being diminished this year. It's just, as you rightly say, we're living through a cost of living crisis. Expense is the key word. Hopefully it's not going to cost as much as people have been predicting. There have been some outrageous figures, like 250 million. If you go back to 1953, that was £1.5 million, which in today's terms is £47 million. Much longer route, much more decorations. I remember down the Mall, there were four-legged triumphal arches, and hanging from the top of them were crowns that were lit up at night. London was bedecked with decorations. Not so much this year, but the sense of the ceremony and the sense of the occasion has not been diminished.
Dickie, we'll come back to you shortly. You're watching special coverage of the coronation of King Charles.
When my mama succeeded and became queen, when my grandfather died so young, I ended up becoming heir to the throne aged 4. It must have been a terrible shock in many ways. You can imagine at that age when presumably she'd hoped that she'd have a chance to do other things and, you know, bring up her family.
To be thrust into that role at 25, and as we know, Charles has had so much more time to prepare, but this event has been carefully choreographed down to the most minute detail, and there'll be plenty to see throughout. But let's take a look at some of the really key moments and when we expect to see them.
The doors to Westminster Abbey are open now, as you've been seeing, and we're likely to see more arrivals from around 9 a.m. London time. They're streaming in. I saw
Lionel Richie.
I saw Nick Cave already in there. The King's procession, of course, will set off from the palace at 7:20. Can't wait to see that. Arriving at Westminster Abbey for the service to begin at 8:00 Eastern time, and that will last about 2 hours.
The coronation procession begins immediately afterwards, snaking its way back to Buckingham Palace. Then the event will conclude with the royal family on the balcony to witness a spectacular 6-minute flypast around 11:30 this evening. And I think one of the things that Pete, you and I have been enjoying over the past couple of days is looking back at this wonderful old vision. And this is actually taken within Buckingham Palace. It was after the coronation, and it was before the family stepped out on the balcony for the flypast. So you can see there, that's Charles and Anne together. I mean, you wonder just how many memories they actually have of that day.
Seems to have passed through the generations. Was it young George, Louis, I think, who had his hands over his eyes or in his ears when the flypast was on last time? But that's a lovely stuff. There you go, Charles and Anne and the late Duke of Edinburgh and the late Queen before they stepped out onto the balcony. And all these years later, 70 years on, that young man is now going to be King Charles III. Mm. He is 74 years old. He will be there with his Queen, Camilla. Who would have thought? Who would have thought? And then, of course, William will be next, and then George. At 74, you wonder how long he will sit on the throne.
What are you trying to do here, Pete?
Oh, no. I'm not looking forward to the next coronation. We'll give him, checking. You know, 10, 15 years or so. But you do wonder, and a great moment. And, of course, William will be the one who kneels at Charles' feet tonight and pay homage to the King.